time now for an update from Fox Carolina News and Fox Carolina Weather. Weather rates certified most accurate.
Good Saturday evening to you. I'm Shale Ramin with a look at your flash briefing. A one-year-old baby is dead because of a deadly accident. The Spartanburg County coroner says the baby boy and a 33-year-old died along this road, Country Club Road. Troopers say three other people were also hurt when a car was going east and then went off the left side of the road, hitting a tree. The coroner says the baby was just, again, a one-year-old named Jabari Hall, and that second victim is Jasmine Sector. And firefighters say a plane goes down in the middle of a Spartanburg County neighborhood this afternoon. We know three people were hurt along St. James Drive. As you can see, we were out on scene all afternoon. The FAA is currently investigating. We're talking to someone who witnessed this all right in their backyard, if you can even imagine that. Those details are going to be coming up on the 10 o'clock news. And something else that is shocking is, unfortunately, the hurricane that is heading towards Louisiana. Meteorologist Bob Trihe's been keeping an eye on it. So, Bob, it sounds like it might make landfall as a Category 4.
It could, you know, and we're hearing words like catastrophic and life-threatening, Shale, with Ida as it's bearing down on the Louisiana Gulf Coast. It could be a devastating hurricane for them and New Orleans. Now, it's the 16-year anniversary of Katrina tomorrow, the landfall. So on that anniversary, we're going to have landfalling Ida probably early afternoon and as a Category 4 near or just west of New Orleans. And that puts New Orleans on the real rough side of this storm. Now, 2 a.m., you can see 125 mile per hour winds. We're going to be seeing this storm going over very warm water in the Gulf of Mexico to low depths, meaning that it's got a lot of warm water to work with. There is nothing that is going to weaken this storm. It's only going to strengthen. And then as we go into tomorrow morning, you can see how it's bearing down on the Gulf Coast of Louisiana. We're talking about 10 to 15 foot storm surges there, and in New Orleans around Lake Pontchartrain, 4 to 8 foot storm surges. They have updated their levee system there, but we're going to be seeing just so much water coming in there and rain falling from the sky in the order of 10 to 15 inches. Hopefully everything holds okay for them during this event tomorrow. And then we'll see Ida moving to the north as a tropical storm weakening through Mississippi. And the good news for the upstate, it's going to be tracking through western and central parts of Tennessee. Obviously not good for them. They had that devastating flooding there across central Tennessee last weekend. And it looks like Ida could move right over them again, but it's going to be staying to our west and north as we go through Tuesday and Wednesday. That means lower impacts from this system. And here we go with the GFS model tracking it, making landfall across the Louisiana Gulf Coast as we go into Sunday and then moving to the north. So we're going to be seeing two dry and hot days Sunday into Monday for the upstate. And then here comes Ida moving to our west and northwest. And we will start to see some showers from this later on Tuesday night and on into Wednesday. But the severe threat is low, as we'll see the main energy from this tracking off to our north as we go into Wednesday. And then after that, we dry it out really nice Thursday into the weekend. Upstate for tonight, mostly clear, very mild and muggy by morning, only lows in the low 70s. And for the mountains, a little cooler for you into the mid 60s with mostly clear skies. 92 on Sunday, 93 on Monday. Heat index values close to 100 degrees. So, yeah, summer is still in full gear, even though September is just around the corner. And then we increase our shower chances Tuesday, a 40% chance of rain with Ida 90 degrees, then a 60% chance on Wednesday, 85. Then after that, it's going to be drier and cooler. Highs into the low to mid 80s Thursday and Friday. Overnight lows back into the mid 60s by the end of the 7-day period. And for the mountains, 87 for you on Sunday, increasing showers Monday. Better chance of rain Tuesday and Wednesday. You're closer to that center of Ida there. And then drier, much cooler for you. 50s as we go into the end of the week, into next weekend. For continuing coverage, make sure you check out the following newscast. You can also find us on the Fox Carolina News app, Facebook.com, and YouTube.com as well. Have a great night. Right.